Good evening, ladies and gentlemen.
Good evening.
My name is Abram Emerson. I represent the Snake Legacy Project and the Black Power Chronicles, the local committee. We're presenting to you this evening our reach out effort into our local community and into the younger people. Okay? Our first mandate is for us who come out of the Black Power Movement is to chronicle our experiences. So that people, especially the young people around who are the new activists, will know, have a foundation which they can look to. Our next mandate is to reach out to our younger people, okay? This is part of our reach out. We know that through poetry, we can find a connection. We understand that we need to create cultural bonds. Now, in 1965, Willie Reese and Stokely Carmichael, on the Selma March, chanted Black Power. At that point in time, was created a whole new cultural phenomenon. Africa wasn't about Tarzan no more. It wasn't about processed hair no more. Okay? It was about being proud of who you are, standing up, okay? And understanding that power runs things. SNCC had a bad experience at the 1964 Democratic Convention. Came back understanding that power was the name of the game. And set forth through their organizing efforts and set forth to produce the first Black Panther Party in Alabama in 1965. In Lyons County, Alabama, where the people were able to use the Black Panther symbol, just like the Democratic Party used the donkey, like the Republican Party used the elephant, in order to identify the people who were of their interest when they went to the polls. After which you had a spread of a cultural phenomenon. You had a new renaissance. Poets came out of everywhere. You had the likes of Haki Murabuti. You had the likes of Amira Baraka, Sonia Sanchez, Nikki Giovanni, and loads of different poets and writers and playwrights across this country that put out literature to connect with our people. We here in San Antonio had a local SNCC chapter. And tonight, we are the ones who are presenting this to you. And I want to introduce to you first to talk about the local SNCC chapter, Mr. Mario Salas, who was the Minister of Information for SNCC. Thanks.
Thank you, Brother Abram. Let me start off by saying, give yourself a round of applause. It's so nice to see young people. One of the things that we always talked about that we wanted to do was pass on this legacy to the younger generation. Let me tell you, in San Antonio, when we were in SNCC, also in the Black Panther Party, the original Black Panther Party, one of the things that we had to encounter was the segregationist mayor. That mayor was Walter McAllister. They have an expressway named after him, they have a park named after him, and I can go on and on and on about the people whose names are on streets, on different place names and so forth, who were either slave owners, segregationists, or what have you. We had to fight them. When Bobby Joe Phillips, and that's a name I want you to remember, Bobby Joe Phillips was beaten to death on New Braunfels Street, right across the street from the African American Cemetery, real close by, beaten to death by the police. Nothing ever happened, no one was ever charged. So we're looking at police abuse that has extended itself all the way from slavery to even now. So we grew up in that era. We grew up at a time when it wasn't safe to march. We grew up in a time when it wasn't a celebration to march, but you risked your life for marching. And there were several times when the mayor of San Antonio issued shoot to kill orders because we were having demonstrations right downtown where the Black Lives Matter folks were having demonstrations. So I am so happy to see and hear about the Black Lives Matter folks marching in San Antonio, laying down in the street. And I did go out and lay down at North Star Mall with them. I lay down in the street in front of the River Center Mall. And admittedly, some of them had to help me get up after that. But that's the kind of legacy that I see is being passed on, and it should be passed on. I have to say that it's very important. We have some historical material back there. Just look at it. It's not for sale, but it is for you to look at. Those are the books that you have, if you haven't read, those are the ones you need to read. I'm a professor at the University of Texas. I'll be teaching African American studies. And by the way, I need some more students to sign up for my class, Mario Salas. And I would appreciate that if you do, for the spring semester. So, and by the way, you'll be in for a treat, because I teach it. You'll never forget what you learned in my class. You will never, ever forget, because I teach the things that have been ignored. And that's what professors do, at least good ones. They teach the things that are ignored. And when you look at all of the stuff that's ignored and not taught, then you can begin to develop some truism about what took place during the historical epoch. So I'm looking forward to doing that. But tonight, I'm looking forward to hearing from these young folks. And I never knew there was this many young poets in San Antonio. So I can tell you, I love you, I appreciate you, and we will continue to struggle. As the revolutionaries in Angola used to say in Portuguese, a luta continua, which means the struggle continues. Thank you. Gladys Miner, Minister of Defense.
Very happy to be here and see all the people come out. I really don't know what to tell you, except this is not new. This struggle has been going on for thousands of years.
Amen.
Thousands of years, and it hasn't changed one bit. You may wonder, what do I do? How do I fight this? You fight it by living every day. You fight it by not surrendering your dignity and your humanity. Are very important, and since the first man tried to express himself with poetry, we've been fighting that struggle. We've been fighting that struggle in different ways. We fought it then, we fight it now. It has not changed, it's not going to get any better, it's going to always be dangerous. They ain't nothing but a thing, sisters and brothers. Nothing but a thing. Thank you.
Leader of Langston Hughes Theater.
A long time coming, but I know.
I want to welcome and thank everybody for coming. Again, my name is Paul Battle. I was one of the leaders in the Langston Hughes Theater. It was on the Iowa Pine. Those of us, like myself, we were like call ourselves the friends of the poets. Langston Hughes Theater, when we first came and began, it was doing more plays, but it was coming more and more demanding for to pull together a whole cast to put on plays. And we were being influenced by the last poets, Gil Scott and others. But we wanted to start doing more poetry. We had drums and flutes and horns and tambourines. All of us that were part of the theater group's band, for lack of a better word, came from the West Side. So the SNCC movement, or the Black Power movement, involved those of us like myself and the others from the West End. Mario told me recently, just the other day, that it used to be Newcombville. So maybe I'm still referring to it as Newcombville. But one thing, like Mario was saying, for us it started with the killing of Bobby Dole. Black lives have always mattered to us. And that's why we became involved, concerned about his life and our lives and folks' lives. You know, it's always been a fight for for Black Lives Matter. Whether we were talking about the Lincoln and the 30s of being enslaved in those days, it's always been about Black Lives Matter. And for me, I'm happy to see that the struggle does continue. And it continues with you in the room, it continues when you get out in the street. When Abram and Becky and Diane Green came back from the meeting to plan this event, my concern was we didn't want a bunch of old folks just sitting around talking about back in the day. How can we introduce ourselves to the Black Lives Matter movement, and how can we be supportive of their movement? And at the same time, we aren't old and buried and dead. We are organizing in the community. We want to know how can we be supportive of some of those things that we're doing so our communities continue to grow. So let me give it back to Abe because I know. And once again, thank you for coming.
I'm the poet. They shot Malcolm. They shot Martin. Technology's techniques changed to take a nigga out. However they say I die, I get See, they buried Larry today. My friend, he gon' buy it. He overstepped the line. It was crack cocaine, they say. A fighter can only play the game of life so long, he can't hide. Mickey won the internal war, found we could ride the power train. Africa called, the plane was lost. He died in the rain. The Los Angeles, the Mexican connection said, this is the time to bind the line and find freedom from our oppression. Disease filled his body. He died. I say you stand. The door unlocked. The assassin entered. Backed out. The room produced a silent shout. We packed, ran here, lived another day. I still walk. I still live. Still have the bill to pay. Revolutionaries don't live long. Black men die young. Now I wish to call to the microphone Mondrea, my co-host, who will do the first round of open mic poetry.
Anybody happy here tonight? So let's stop making this like a library or a funeral. Is there anybody happy in here tonight? Can we make some noise in here tonight? I know y'all been upset about a couple of things tonight, but it's all right. No, it's all right because we're taking it back to where it's supposed to be. I don't need the government working with me as long as I got this community. You see, if I can go to your house, and if I don't have water running, I can go to your house. And I can get some cold water from your house, but hold on, because see over here, this brother got some sugar. Now y'all might not know about sugar water, but sugar water is good when you ain't got Kool-Aid. And if you got the right kind of coloring, you can put your red in there and then you got Kool-Aid. But I didn't need nobody but us. All I need is you. Everybody looking for the key, but the key was already there. We needed to get back with these elves. The elves had the key in their back pocket. And I just want to say right now, for all of these elders who just spoke, and all who are sitting right here, I want to say an uhuru, a sasa, I want to say thank you, and that I'm still, any chance you sneak around and let me get at your feet, I'm listening. Because I'm hungry, and if anybody else hungry out there, please make some noise with me right now. All right, we got to find another level. Oh, I got you right here. Let me just say this right here. July 30th, I had a massive stroke. But I'm right here. But I'm so excited, so we can spend this poetry together.
We're gonna get everybody. Somebody gonna clap for something. I'm gonna jump them next. So we're gonna do something. We're gonna get everybody together. If y'all ready for some good poetry, say yes.
Yes.
Now I'm gonna work with my people because my people got my list. So we can start calling off these good folk. Are you ready?
Yes.
Amen. Amen. All right. First poet coming to the mic. Y'all put your hands together for the incredible Phyllis Lee, y'all.
I'm very excited about tonight. I want to start with my favorite poet, Langston Hughes, born in 1906 and died in 1967. He is not dead. I too sing America. You see, I am the darker sister. They tell me to eat in the kitchen when company comes. But I laugh, I eat well, and I grow strong. Now tomorrow, when company comes, nobody will dare say to me, eat in the kitchen then. Besides, they'll see how beautiful I am and be ashamed. I too am America. Get up. Langston Hughes, like David in the Bible, speaks of rivers. David in Psalms 1 and 3 speaks of a tree planted by the rivers of water. I've known rivers, ancient as the world, and older than the flow of human blood in human veins. My soul grows deep like the rivers. I bathed in the Euphrates when dogs were young. I built my hut near the Congo, and it lulled me to sleep. I looked upon the Nile and saw pyramids above me. And I heard the singing of the Mississippi. You remember when Abe Lincoln went down to New Orleans? And I've seen its muddy bosom turn all golden in the sunset. I've known rivers, Colorado, Hudson, the San Antonio, ancient, dusty rivers. My soul grows deep like the rivers.
Yes, yes, darling. Mama Phyllis Lee, another round of applause. And just so you can ride this wave with us, I'm blessed to be one of the babies of the movement. And I know we got some babies of the movement as well. And we talked about Slick and we talked about the Panthers, and you know, we're celebrating the 50th anniversary. And I just see my mom and my dad and Chairman Fred and everybody, and they were paving the way for us. I'm gonna ask you for a second, because all of this is the connection from our elders to our young people. So I probably want to bring up maybe the youngest person in the room. Anybody younger than six? Nobody's younger than six? So I am about to bring up the youngest person in the room. We're about to bring up my daughter, Ross Amika Harmon. Come on up, man.
I'm the spirit of Ella Jo Baker, born on December 13, 1903. In Norfolk, Virginia, I graduated from Shaw University as class valedictorian. I began my involvement with the NAACP as class valedictorian in 1940. In 1957, I moved to Atlanta to help organize Martin Luther King's new organization, the Southern Christian Leadership Conference, SCLC. I wanted to assist the new student activists, in organize a meeting at Shaw University, the student year 46. Sit-ins in April 1960. From that meeting, the Student Nonviolent Coordinating Committee, SNCC, was born.
Y'all, let's throw them seeds. We know if we keep doing it like that, that there's gonna be people coming after us, and it's not gonna stop. We gonna see what everybody was talking about, this kid in this land, as long as we keep sowing them seeds. I shake. All right, thank you all. Coming up next, anybody wanna hear another hot poet say yes?
Yes.
Coming right now, I have a pro. Let's bring up right now, this is Antoinette Franklin. Woo! I knew it. You were sitting behind us the whole time. I felt that power. Once again, y'all make another line for Mama Franklin.
Well, it is absolutely a wonderful time to be here. I remember when Cape Radio used to be available for us, and Nikki Giovanni was saying about all the wonderful things about being black. Likes and News inspired me, Maya Angelou, Sonia Sanchez. So it's wonderful to be able to be a poet and give these things back. Not that I have to carry my friend with me, but that's okay. We'll make it work out. The names are many. This is dedicated to my ancestors. I wish to thank them. The kings and queens, the hunters, the warriors, the leather tanners, the basket weavers, the farmers, the poets, the craftsmen, the geos, those who lived through the indignity of capture, enslavement, violation, and brutality, those taken from their homeland to Goree Island, the land of no return. Transported from a home they would never see again. I want them to be proud and know that their struggle was not in vain. I thank the survivors of the Middle Passage. If they had not survived, where would my history be? I honor their presence when the wind rustles morning leaves brightened by the sun. I hear them in my dreams and listen to sages bearing news only a poet can use. Think of my existence, what I was born to be, a fighter for equality. Think of all those people who died so I could taste freedom. Think of the blood-stained banner of heritage left to me. I am more than one people. Their names are African, Scottish, Spanish, Mexican, Choctaw, Seminole, and New Iberian Creole. Think of my people on the banks of the Nile and my great-great-grandmother's rape bearing the slave master's child. My granny said there were no happy slaves on those dusty plantations, and my family wanted the best for me. She spoke of loving God, the love of family, a need for education, and living righteously. Think about the purpose of my purpose in the scheme of things, about the blood-stained banner of courage.
And say, well, they're not listening, we'll keep the stories here. I know elders here, but it's talk on the street. And then there's young people saying, well, the elders in hell and hidden themselves over here, so we got to go for what we know over here. And tonight shows that it's so not true, that bridge is here, that we learn from each other, that we go back and forth. It reminds me of the old meetings of incense and the drummers drumming and then everybody just coming and dancing and doing what they do. Thank you, we cannot stop this. If you're enjoying the words that are coming out right now, I need you to make some noise. I need to know you're out there. These lights are bright, so I can't see you all, so I can only hear you all. I need y'all to make this noise. And if y'all haven't guessed it, I'm a little loud. I know I'm working the mic man to death up there, but thank you for following me. But we gotta make this noise. We got ancestors who are just jumping now that we're together and we're connected. It's not oogity-boogity, it's real, and it's how we got here, and we got to continue sharing that. If I'm alone, stay quiet. Y'all ready to hear another hot poet say yes?
Yes!
Coming up right now. Y'all put y'all hands together. For Ariane to shake y'all.
My name is Amina. I'm proud to be here. I'm honored to be here, humbled to be here.
Happy?
Happy.
I'm enjoying it. I know somebody out there with me.
I feel blessed to be here. I didn't know what a gift it is to be a poet until I started hanging around some of my elders and hearing them speak, so.
All right. Woo.
Yes.
Yo, he was standing outside with the 40 in his hands and the 20 Glock Gat in his pants. Yes, you already know he was black and his jeans was low. Outside, think about sticking up this corner store. You see his pockets was a lint and due was his rent. He steals what he wants because he can't afford what he needs. Shh. Money grows on the bushes, not trees. Previously, he prayed about it, hoping God would help him abide in his current situation. But problems persisted and he was losing his patience, growing weary and waiting. He took matters into his own hands. Did away with God's will, he was making his own plans. And this is his first time, I could tell he wasn't a schemer. He was hesitant, waiting like victims till they checked from FEMA. I wanted to help the brother, so I crossed the street, my feet hitting the concrete in unison with his rapid heartbeat. I took a seat next to him. He knew of God already, so instead I introduced to him my pen. He didn't appreciate the power within, so I I let him hold it. And so he lost control of it. The command on his body, because his hands started to move. On a brown butchered up bag, he had been to the groove of his thoughts. And he began to write. And yo, I've been standing here all night with 50-40 in my hands and a 20 Glock Gat in my pants. Yes, you already know I'm black, my jeans is low. Outside, think about sticking up this corner store. You see, my pockets is a flint that do is my rent. I steal what I want because I can't afford what I need. Shh, money grows on the bushes, not trees. Previously, I had a 9-to-5. I didn't always live alive, but I've been replaced by machines that work faster than I. I want to do more than stick it to the man. I want to curse his seed because of his greed. I cannot feed mine. Like Invisible Man, I was blind to the position I was in. Working my butt off to impress these men, and this boy got promoted after days. I've been working for years, still get paid minimum wage. That's why to this gun I hold a tight grip. I'm making somebody pay for my pink slip. Women hugging their purses because their fathers was racist. Women defeated to the stereotype for taking, and there was no more ink in the pen, so I whipped out another one and gave it to him.
Yeah.
And the government is cheap. Welfare don't help my family to eat. Pay my taxes, still got potholes in my street. My neighborhood don't have welcome signs. I only see the president here during election time. Reluctantly promising housing repairs, but fresh paint don't cover the blood stains there with the eyes that stare at gunfights. Evidence got lost so that girl who got shot died. Dick Cheney popped the cap, it's all fun and games, but it's 15 a life if a black man does the same, and that's why to this gun. On this pen, I hold a tight grip. Y'all, she was walking outside away from some man with an empty Magnum wrapper in her hand. And yes, the Sage report, she was black, her skirt was too short. 20-something, a hoe of some sort. You see, she had college dreams. She wanted her degree, but when it grows on the bushes, not trees. I wanted to help the sister, so I crossed the street, my feet hitting the concrete, and you listen with her rapid heartbeat. I took a seat next to her. She knew of God already, so instead I introduced her. I'm
more for
Fred. Hey, Mark Clark is homeboy. Let's talk about homeboys for a second. You got so many people who be Facebook hating, underrating, disrespecting, talking about sneak dissing, high-fiving you, and then they on these books disrespecting. And I'm saying it was a brother who never really slept while this man was asleep, lost his life, a crooked bullet took him out at ease from Peoria. I remember you, Mark Clark, I say, peace. So now I'm just gonna start speaking for peeps who took trips on ships with no sheets. We got to talk about the Sankofa and how dirty they did our women. They said, I want you pregnant. We would just take a knife and open you up. And we, so many people playing soccer, but I remember soccer when it was just these children, they were stomping on them on these hardwood boards, on these wicked ships. I speak for peeps who took trips with no sheets. They said, I'm gonna be on hunger strikes. Men were strong at the time. They said, no, we gotta keep these Negroes eating. So they took this hammer and cracked out the front of their mouth. They say, niggas ain't got to smile. All they need to do is work, and it's working out. So all you ice grillers, come on, let's smile again. We still blessed by our team. Hey, man, we're gonna talk about people who took trips on ships with no sheets. People were talking about that. We got to just have black power. But I want to go back like Chairman Fred said. Let's go on and have this oppressed people just need to find their power. I don't care what color you are now. If you're oppressed, I need you to roll with me now because I understand that the oppression of my oppressed is not just the oppression now. I understand that I have to have an impression. I have to start speaking lessons, and I'm going to speak life now. So let's talk about the life of those who took trips on ships with no sheets. They told them that it was just darkness, and even in your own foot had your own diarrhea. Can you imagine eating the inside of your biohazard and you still live? Don't get mad at me because it wasn't what I was brought up to be. They don't want to talk about it no more, but the Sankofa and me keep saying that we need to keep telling these stories of people who took trips on ships with no sheets because what their sacrifice was. Still here. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Hey, I want to hear the black one say yeah! Yeah. Oh, you hear both sides? Y'all put y'all hands together for Philip Joyner. Let's get it in!
As I travel through what used to be mountains, wildlife, and trees, I see the beauty of what was and still is. Your wonderful works on the landscape of Earth. As I sail on ocean banks, the sight, sound, and smell calms me as I long to be near it, even when it's out of my sight. I wonder, was it just for me and all the people who can truly see? You're in the water, you're in the trees, and you're all over me. Those are just some of the things that make me wonder about the great, great wonder. My wonder, he's the lover and the keeper of my soul. The wonder that makes me wonder, my sweet wonder, yeah, lover of mine, my soul, you protected me when I was young, you carry me as I grow old. My sweet wonder, lover of my soul. Sometimes I wonder, I sit and wonder about the great, great wonder, lover of my soul.
Something, and I can learn something. You know, everybody want a dollar, a quarter, a nickel. They want. I got to be better. And I got my shiny suit on. You know, I got all this stuff in my hair. And I just want to be an artist. And thank you all tonight for sharing. Every time I host and I see the artists come and touch this mic, I say thank you for sharing the piece of you and me. So. We still got more people, so I need y'all to put y'all hands together. If you're ready for another poet, say yes, yes! Yes! There's a Fernando out there. Fernando? No, there you go. Y'all put y'all hands together for the brother Fernando in the building, y'all.
Too hard, for the boys who dream too big and too loud, the boys who think and speak life, breathing out their curiosity, boys who try to change to fit in, who try to dim their own light so that they never shine brighter than those around them, boys who pray and pray every day for normal eyes, normal skin, normal hair, who hide behind masks of deception and dishonesty to walk the streets at night undetected. I always thought something was wrong with me. I felt difficult. I felt out of place to understand. My skin so dark and so brown, rugged, tough like tar, tried to scrub the iniquity off my skin. The iniquity of being black. The burden of being perpetually flawed. The curse of growing too tall, walking too fast, working too hard, dreaming too big, and too loud. I restricted my wild tongue, placed a bit over my mouth that the birds of the night before me held in place. I felt my teeth shatter, and each piece fell down my throat, down the rabbit hole. Each piece cutting the lining of my throat, the pain of stillborn questions and answers that never, ever saw the light of day. I lied face down with my hands tied behind my back. I lay still, not to move, not to draw any attention. I closed my eyes, rolled on my side, laid down for my brethren. In this state, in this position, I cause no trouble. I do no harm. I'm not being difficult. I'm not dreaming too big or too loud. This is for the boys who lost themselves to be found. Why must we lose to win? Why must we die to live? We die face down on the ground. Only then do people say our names. Hear our names. Know our names. Y'all get it, brother. Another round of applause. If it's set you know to, you're going to want to hear that piece. Don't stop writing. Please don't stop writing. Yeah. Coming up next.
Some people just, they can suck the life out of you with their pieces because it's so heartfelt. And you'd be talking like that good movie that you'd be watching and knowing that you've seen it 20 times, but it's like, that one part is still right there. It's like, I knew it was coming, but, that's the system right here. Y'all put y'all hands together for Mama Keita in the building, y'all.
That I'm getting ready to do is an old piece, but it's new for y'all. I thought it was appropriate. This is called The Ghost of the Trees, because we should not forget where we came from. We should not forget our ancestors and what they had to go through, because we're actually living that today. So I want y'all to take a journey with me as I talk about the ghosts of the trees. I hear the voices in my head, the suffering of the dead, the history that they want us to forget, the slaughter of those looked upon as animals, and still we aren't really free yet. Every branch, every leaf, encounters the souls of that they tried to keep. Those souls live within me. I see the images before me. And when I close my eyes, they haunt me. And as I try to forget, they taunt me. Because they say I'm over the slave mentality, making excuses about racial brutality, looking for any reason, lynching season, to find something that they could classify as treason. And still today, deaths are on the uprise. Do the ghosts of the trees, true justice, it's time to fight and rise. Their voice, never heard, never had a choice. Singing the old gospel spirituals embedded with secret messages of rejoice, I cried about what they had to endure. In a land of hatred, a disease that came from bigotry, a disease that they called nigger, where torture and death was their only cure. But even though it may be no surprise, my ancestors still reign as kings and queens in the skies. And my mama and daddy taught me that I was more than a color. And I taught the same to my baby sisters and brothers. Cause you see, I am like no other. I can see through racism undercover. And I stand for justice for my people as I bow to my knees looking up to the holy steeple. The ghosts of the trees have spoken, and their spiritual souls will forever be golden. And to those mothers who saw their children choking on a noose that they prayed would somehow be broken. Harriet Tubman had that silver token to board the train of free at last, hiding in the shadows, fighting time and the moments of being labeled the outcast, of being beat because of skin color, the same skin they tried to hide with masks. But I choose to never forget, because our fight to be an equal hasn't exactly been won yet. Their blood is my blood and flows within my veins. The history they walk before me leads me as I journey down the road of I'm not good enough. I can never do enough. My skin is not light enough. My work, although excellent, is just never good enough. I am an extension of my ancestors. Did I mention? The facts of human slavery still bring about tension. The ghosts of the trees are here and they shall never leave. In the history that they had no choice to reside, we must have unity and pride. Because the history that they did before, they took our history like thieves. And we should always remember the ghosts of the trees. Peace. Thank you.
There was a lady on the block, her name was Miss Fox, and she just took care of everybody on the block, and she used to make homemade ice cream. And so what happened was the first person who could rap that whole song without missing a beat got the ice cream. So yes, and that's just what you all do, and we take that to heart. So my time is dwindling down. I'm gonna get the chance to introduce one more fire person. So if y'all ready to hear some good words, say yes, yes, yes. Yes, 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 yes. Come into the stage right now. Y'all put y'all hands together for Samaj Griffin, y'all.
Guided by business from past transgressions committed against my ancestors for centuries, and I wonder, do I have it in me? Do I have the envy to be accepted and make it in a land where racism is supposedly banned, but yet I'm labeled as an African, not just an American? Daily reminded from the blinded, better known as society, that preach peace and love, but really they hate me in private. As I look on, I wonder houses that I don't quite fit in. But still, because I'm black and we all the same, I don't stand out. Because when I speak of success, the child leaves the room and is filled with doubt. But if I drop a dope line, that gives for 2, 7, 4, like literally slaying that coke line, my people will shout. I find this baffling with the battles we face daily trying to win the war. We're more concerned with what rappers on tour if she can bend over and touch the floor. You see, my great-great-grandmother, she had to bend over too, and she didn't have cotton in her hand when she came up. They would beat and kill you. So you see, I'm guided by business of past transgressions committed against my ancestors for centuries. And I wonder, do I have it in me? Do I have it in me to witness the unfair treatment of my sisters and brothers and overlook the unjust murders and the claim it had nothing at all to do with color? Do I work my 9 to 5 and hoping to get by, and just because I'm black, opportunity doesn't even try to pass me by? As I listen to the lies and I'm telling them we found a better guy, and I watch another man get the job where I know he's substantial underqualified. And as I look on and despise, bitterness flaming in my eyes, but consuming my pride, I hold my head high and try not to cry, wondering why. And supposing the land of the free and the home of the brave, not even 300 years ago, your great, my great, and his great grandparents were slaves. Oh, but it's supposed to be a new day and age. One where the Confederate flag still waves, and I can't even go to church and pray. I may be slain by the KKK. All right, peace out of mind. It's a damn shame that hatred and ignorance is so profound, and the people known as society remain oblivious. Really, I'm just curious, is that anybody out there feeling it? Can I get a witness? Wait, but you see, in this country, a witness doesn't matter. See, I can watch that cop make that boy brain splatter when I go to town and assassinate my character. Therefore, my testimony don't even matter. R.I.P. Mike Brown. So you see, I'm guided by a business of parents, strange guests, and committed against my ancestors for centuries, and I wonder, do I have it in me? See, maybe I'm too in touch with my spiritual mind, and I see the devil behind this society that's so blind it tries to hold my race in a bind. We're already racing with time to get our lives in order for the divine. So I'm on a different mission than the norm, because I'm on a mission to see my I'm on a mission to see my people truly praised, because we're so gifted, and all this time, I don't see how you can miss it. See, I don't think I have it in me, because I can't walk around aimlessly, brainlessly, told to be thankful for whatever they gave to me. Really, what's 40 acres in the music? You plan to pay me off for a buck or two like an insurance company because they know they're going to weigh more than you? See, America in the beginning was built on the backs of minorities, including Indians, but in history, get no recognition, only recognized for a couple of inventions. See, it don't make no sense to me how we can go on days and days about Leonardo da Vinci, but only seconds about Eli Whitney. Y'all forgive me, it's just that my grandfather told me, son, remember your history. Honestly, it really sickens me. Now they tell me, they say, hold up and have faith. We should live to fight another day. Let's not let anger be the way. But it's America today, all the sunshine has turned to gray, and all that hopefulness and faith in our hand is withered away. So I drop to my knees and pray for the Lord to make a way, because now my business has my mind enslaved, because we still treated like slaves. If my boss says something to me today, he might not make it out okay. So please, Lord, I pray, help me make it through this day.
You about to start a whole other thing in here. Why is it always the ones who say, I'm new at this, I'm trying to do this? Why is them folks who come out here and be like, any poet know when somebody come in and say, this is my first time, or forgive me, just strap your seatbelt on, because it's about to go down. Anyway, thank you so much. My name is Brother Montrea. They call me the Urban Griot. My important thing is that before I leave you, we leave you with information. We leave you with information that our children are not getting. So just bear with me 1 second. We're gonna leave you with this tidbit. You talk to your children and you go to them and you say, honey, who was the very first African-American female millionaire? Raise your hands, y'all, my honeys. Now, come on, raise your hand.
Look, don't nobody want to answer? That's right, Madam C.J. Walker. Except she had a teacher. And her teacher's name was Annie Minerva Turnbull Pope Malone. She lived in Illinois. She had the products that were called Poro products, and I didn't even know what I had because my great aunt had all her products. Now, she had a student by the name of Madam C.J. Walker, but in true history, the first billionaire was Miss Malone out of Illinois. Just to let you know how incredible she was, she used to collect dolls, and in each doll she would have a diamond, and when she would take those diamonds, she would go to different schools, and whoever had good grades, she would give them the doll. And that doll would be used for their education. It is important that we never let anyone else tell our story. Again, we need to put these ancestors in the right places where they are and understand why our princesses and our queens love dolls. Coming up next right now, we're gonna bring the father of all this back up here. I'd like to introduce you and his heart, King Abram, y'all.
Thank you, my friend.
Thank you.
This was the first round of our open mic. At this point right now, we want to give you some information about the next project that we're working on. I would like attorney Natasha Sherrod to come to the forefront, please.
Thank you all for coming out tonight. We are so, so happy with the turnout. As King Abram said, I'm attorney Natasha Sherrod. Our next event is coming up in mid to late January. It is going to be a Know Your Rights workshop. It's going to be a collaboration of attorneys, myself and others who will be there to educate you on how to exercise your rights when you're stopped. Our goal is to cover the most common stops that you may encounter, whether it's a DWI stop. I know some of y'all have baby mama drama, baby daddy drama, so we're gonna cover assault, bodily injury questions, things of that nature. And of course, just when you're just out and police say that you're under reasonable suspicion. Please make sure we have current contact information for you, cell phone or email, so that we can let you know the exact date, time, and location, okay? And we also want to get feedback from you. If there's anything in particular you would like the attorneys to cover, please let us know. You can email me directly at lawyer@natashasherrod.com. That's lawyer at NATASHASHERROD.com. Also, if you're on this side of town, please come and visit me. I'm at 2836 East Houston Street. Just moved in a couple of weeks ago. So I would love for you to drop by, introduce yourself, and let me know what you want to know when dealing with the police. Thank you.
Thank you, Natasha. At this point right now, I want to call to the microphone Mr. Jonathan David Jones, who is a local Black Lives Matters organizer and poet. I want to ask him to inform the people as to what is happening with the local movement for Black Lives Matter and to give us some poetry.
Thank you. Thank you. No justice, no peace.
Right.
I was just thinking about that. I was sitting there. There's this thing I always say that love and peace is not the absence of conflict. Love is diving headfirst into conflict for the sake of peace and in the name of love. So before I do poetry, just real brief, anybody that's seen me speaking to where I never talk about my activity when it comes to activism without mentioning an individual who probably isn't going to like what I'm about to do, but a man that I've always worked so closely with, who's become like a brother to me. I grew up in the movement with him, a fellow organizer named Mike Lowe. He's actually in the room right now, up top. This man, fire is contagious. And if it's not me out there, it's usually him. The running joke has been that that's Malcolm on Martin. We balance each other out so well. So I always like to mention him when I talk about any work that I do when it comes to the movement for Black Lives. So as far as the local chapter, there isn't a local chapter of Black Lives Matter. Black Lives Matter does have official members, and it is an official organization. They recently put a pause on opening new chapters. So what we usually do is we work and we advocate for Black lives here in San Antonio. Mike being the founder of SATX4, and myself, I just like to tell people my title is Concerned Citizen. So we've done a lot of things recently. I don't know if you guys know the name Marquise Jones, Anthony Scott, Norman Cooper. These are people who have died here in San Antonio, Texas. I know we know a lot of the national and renowned names like Eric Gardner and Trayvon Martin, who we also advocate and fight for, but we can't forget that we have issues here in San Antonio, Texas. Anthony Scott was killed in February 2016, that's this year. A lot of people don't even know his name. He was gunned down by police officers because they thought his cell phone was a gun. That's San Antonio, Texas, home of the Spurs and all these great restaurants. So another thing that we've done recently, we pushed very hard against what was known as the SAPOA contract, San Antonio Police Officers Association contract. We did a lot of work against that. There's just small things in the contract where it says, I'm just gonna give you a super, very brief overview. For example, let's say an officer who had a case of intentional violence passed 5 years, that intentional violence case cannot be used against him. An officer that committed an act, then he was suspended for 3 days or less. After 2 years, that case, that incident can no longer be used against him. It gets changed in the records to a written reprimand. We recently had an officer that sexually assaulted a woman while she was handcuffed. He was suspended for 3 days. According to the contract, 2 years from now, that gets changed to a written reprimand. The only person that can see it is the chief of police. We're not allowed to see that record. So things like that that happen here in San Antonio, people kind of just think that this stuff doesn't happen here, that it doesn't relate here. I know the mayor herself likes to say we don't have those problems here in San Antonio, Texas. Racism doesn't work like that. You don't take 450 years of systemic oppression and it just disappears because we have Greg Popovich. It's not how it works. All that being said, I'm also on the Mayor's Council for Police Community Relations. My brother Mike is as well. But we have to continue to work. We constantly continue to work. We do a lot more than protesting. We've done community gatherings. We've done cookouts. We've done all sorts of things because we do believe justice is holistic. We're not just anti-cop. We're pro-freedom.
Yeah.
So. All that being said, man, I'm going to go ahead and spit some poetry from you guys, man, because that's where it all started for me. I say so often, the activist leads the poet, but the poet feeds the activist in me. And it was through poetry that I developed that sensitivity for emotion, that ability to absorb the grieving and the anger and spit it back out and create something beautiful, rather that be through my words or my actions. So before I go forward, I always give this disclaimer, the poet in me enjoys the snaps and the claps, but the minister in me only prays that you hear the message. So I pray that you would listen with your hearts and not just your ears. So this poem I'm about to share is so apt for what we're doing. We're talking about the SNCC Legacy Project, and I'm just so grateful for my elders here, man, because when I met with them first, man, I was so in awe, I had to take a selfie. And they're just like, they're just laughing at me. It's just like, you know, I guess that's what the kids do nowadays, man. But I just love it. It does my heart some good to feel energized and inspired and encouraged by people from a generation before you, when so often people from my generation are used to being criticized, you know, by a thing we call ageism, you know, by the older generation usually. And so I'm just so grateful for it. And so this poem is called Status Update. I'm going to be speaking from the context of a slave, but using a language that's pertinent to our generation. So if you're very active on social media, you'll catch a lot of the references. But I believe it's so apt. I've performed this poem before, but I believe it's so apt as we're talking about things like Sankofa, looking back to move forward, reaching back to see our future. So, let me go ahead and let the poem tell it. So I would like to introduce myself, but I haven't developed any ads yet, so take what you can about what and where I am from my web address. www.blackhistory-freedom.com. World wars waging stops. Black history's dash to freedom. Backslash after backslash stop. Come on, man. Hashtag pain, hashtag bloody, hashtag neglected, hashtag forgotten. Hashtag broken, hashtag slaughtered. Hashtag remember me. Hashtag we fought, hashtag we made it, hashtag we're here. Hashtag where? Hashtag, oh no. Hashtag, did we make it or did we just get close? You see, I'm no longer around, but I progress with age, so though I'm no longer around, you can still look at my page. Because I made my mark in history. And I had to catch up with videos since sending a private message couldn't get anyone to listen to me. But you'll always be able to find me amongst the chains. From following link after link. As my ancestors fight a war meant for the divines, writing down their pains, passions, and fears, time after time, just to have it all reduced down to a million hits from a vine. See, I was forced to watch children whipped that weren't even mine. Now here's a tough thought to swallow. Imagine me, hashed and tagged beneath the scorching sun, and then praying that my wife and children could follow. Because it was less about segregation and more about separation. Because I can endure this if I just had my people. But as my friends list unwillingly started to dwindle, I got a whiff of pure evil. And just as slowly as these long days, my family became nothing more than a page. You see, the very next time I saw my wife was on a posted picture. The caption read, sold, slave. And as time progressed, oppressive turned aggressive. And war approached fast, and you could search for a name, so no longer were we concerned about if our profiles would change. See, it was strange. It wasn't until I got my face in that book that I was finally able to leave my post. See, not until I got my deceased face in that book was I finally able to leave my post. You see, I was forced to fight a war from a country that had yet to recognize me as a man. A human. All because of my hue. Man. That's crazy. But have you checked the status of lately? Tagged in comments, daily degraded by distant, daunting demons with pale faces. Never knowing what to say or think, not even knowing where I was dislocated. So you see, we never had dyslexia. It was displacement. But unlike now, no one was ever able to look at a page about me. All the while, everything about me can only be seen by looking at my racial profile. And I couldn't afford to leave you any notes to read, so all I could afford to do was leave you with Instagraphic pictures in desperate hope that you follow me. But just know that in order for us to stay on track, I have to forewarn you that I'll never be able to follow you back. Because forward progression is key. And I once realized the thought of a day where my people would look nothing like me. But my eyes begin to swell as I scroll down my page and see that our status hasn't changed. The majority still reads slaves. Now imagine me amazed as I saw a brother stand upon a stage and preach about change. But that's where it gets strange, because though most of us agree, we still act the exact same. Yellow, right? You only live once. Now with that much, I agree. But knowing that you know that is exactly what I'm ashamed of when I see, is this truly what you've decided to do with your life? Never once was I given the pleasure to be concerned about the report of my status being liked. All I cared about is that the report of our status would be right. So instead of following the roles of world stars, hip-hop your way into purpose. We were forced to live a life of slavery, but now I see people doing so on purpose. I've been following your videos closely. The constant reposting of excuses are getting old. Are you not aware that the average life expectancy of blacks at my time was 22 years old? We had already spent our lives in the same amount of time that it takes you to waste it. Constant laughing and knockout games and sharkeishas all promoting the very one thing that we sought to abolish. Hatred. So stop searching for your problems in your book and just face it. Many of you are confused about what to do, but the answer is so basic. Bring the love and stop the hatred. Don't just believe in change, help us make it. Someone needs to draw the line and then trace it. This is your story now. Your future and your life. Many of you are watching your own people do wrong than to pacify your own sins. You're telling them that it's all right, but we're willing to be ostracized before we compromise so you can spare me your likes. But I'd appreciate it if you'd share. I came in search of a generation that cares. You've compromised your dreams so much that I think you'd have some to spare. Started from the bottom, now we're here. Where? Started from the bottom that got us here when we need to be out there. You see, there was once a time. And like the sweetest birds that sing, I heard freedom ring. I wonder if I could get a retweet. We wholeheartedly appreciate your monuments and celebrations. But people already know what we did. That's no mystery. Don't become so concerned with our past that you forget about the future status of Black history. Thank you.
Black liberation continuum continues. Short poem. My man, we need men. Black men, bold men, bodacious cone men. No dope men, hope men, up against the man men. Warrior men, spirit men, soul men, brave men to save. Next round, my co-host, Bouquet.
Greetings. It's a pleasure to be here with you all. I'm going to do a piece that some of you probably know me for, or one of the pieces you know me for. God, I can't do this with this jacket on. I am surprised at how I don't feel heavy, because there's so much love in this room. We have a bright future ahead of us, because we understand where we've been, and we're getting it. Let me just do this piece. Shut up, stop talking so much. I'll be that saxophone, I'll be that trombone, I'll be that cello. My voice is a microphone, phone. I am piano keys,
My walk is a symphony. My heels click like a tambourine. Yeah, music is my everything. So give me jazz, jazz that I am. Give me jazz, jazz that I am. Give me jazz, jazz that I am. I am jazz, yeah. Give me a felonious monk kind of funk to smooth my wrinkled morning blues. Yeah. Cruise down my memory banks with subdued bebop bruise melodies. Rain down my soul from the heavenlies. Fat, cold drops of precipitation. I think my flesh was awaiting its creation through Coltrane stained saxophone notes chained to clay and Adam's missing rib. And as Dizzy Gillespie caressed me, molded and shaped me to the sound of supple trumpet toots, the bravado of my heart began to shoot the roof of my mouth, and a jazzy, fat, nasty sound came spouting out. I let the pitch of it shout over Kitty Clark drum taps have a musical spat with the rainbow in my smile. And for a while, I drowned my mind in the lines of an old Louis Armstrong song as the breath from his cheeks pushed me along. And from then on, I knew my spirit belonged with Dexter Gordon great, so follow me among the ranks with Charlie Parker and Johnny Hodges as the instrumental music massages my temples, changing the tempo of my thoughts. Cause lately, I've been dwelling on Duke Ellington keystrokes, mental images float off his elegance and with relevance for my thought patterns to linger in limbo with Nina Simone as Cap Calloway echoes his resonance of a hi, 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 ho. Twirling in a yellow pinstripe suit suit with matching hat to boot, I tell you, I am a recruit for a jazzy dream team, so stream me in Doc Perry's piano pounding, gleam me in a montage of cool and big band swing, whirl me on the surface of a melodic color scheme, Harlem mahoganies and Dutch, DC chocolate brown, catch me in this movement of symphonic sound, and I will never come down from the very high fountain. My blood is a pump, so give me a felonious monk kind of funk, a true black Billie Holiday groove, a luscious Lena Horne tune, a croon from Sarah Vaughan to Spina, mid-morning press for my bunch of blues, cause I want to be smooth, so smooth, daddy, is jazz, as jazz, a renovated soul and innovative from old and inundated with cold drops of rain, just as inflamed as they, carnivorously drunk with this neoclassic felonious monk kind of funk, so give it to me, live it through me, say it to me, play it through me. I am a vessel, an instrument, a significant infant, adolescent, an imminent woman projecting, expressing this air-inspired art form. My body performs in every minute, minute of every passing day for decades. You can hear me jazz, woodwind, percussion, string, with discussion, brass, like is, baby, I am. Containing, becoming, and being pizzazz, and I have as much as with such class a felonious monk, kind of funk, jazz, 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 that I am. So I want to bring up a gentleman. And I want to say thank you to everyone, but I want to give a shout out to the non-African Americans that were brave enough to say, I stand and ally with you in your cause, because we have to make our brothers and sisters' causes our own. We embrace them and we move forward together. Amen? Ashe, whatever you want to say. So I want to bring up this gentleman who is woke, as we like to say. He's brand new to being a grandfather. He just had his first grandbaby. He's a writer and a journalist. Put your hands together for the next poet to this mic, Don Mathis.
Man, 47 years ago, a fellow named James Baldwin wrote The Fire Next Time. Because that's how the world's going to end, with The Fire Next Time. Well, about a year ago, a woman wrote a book called The Fire This Time. And Ivy Taylor wants everybody in the city to read it. You go to the library, there's 10 copies right there by the checkout desk. When I was a teenager, I read Black Like Me. I wanted to read more. I read Autobiography of Malcolm X. These books are still in print. Go back to the source and read this stuff. There's an excellent book. There's an audio book of it. And I call it the Reverend Martin Luther King's Greatest Hits. It's called A Knock at Midnight. And it's his most popular sermon that he gave throughout his life. So somebody asked Martin Luther King, he says, what are your favorite books? He said, Matthew, Mark, Luke, and John. So I stole this from Matthew. Our landlord who lives upstairs, you are the greatest. Your apartment is fantastic. Your lease agreement is okay for us as it is for you. Today we ask you for a break, just like we give a guy down the hall a break. Don't make it too easy for us to cheat others. Keep our cars and power running smooth because you are the best CEO of the most earth-friendly corporation that we ever saw. Say la. This is my gospel. You've heard of the gospel of Matthew, Mark, Luke, and John. This here's the gospel for everyone. I believe in life, laughter, love, and all that. A person you can count on, a person to watch your back. I'm a believer, a singer, a pacifist, a humane humanist. I think everyone should seek their own way, and no one is at the right to force you to pray. You're free to praise your deity of choice, to worship in silence, or to raise your voice. It's fine if you want to do a Buddhist dance, or if you want to do an Indian chant. If your belief is a disbelief in God, that's okay with me and my sanctified dog. I support your freedom to do as you please, just as long as you don't hurt me or the trees. For everything is precious on planet Earth, and I confirm and respect everyone's worth. I see the dignity in every person, and I see equity in human relations. An aspect of our association is our motivation for social action. Truth and meaning and the right of one's conscience are keystones of our community's essence. What is important for social interaction? Liberty, justice, and human compassion. We are liberal, but we're also religious. We are diverse, but we hold a main purpose. Spiritual growth is a goal to espouse. The earth is similar to a mighty house. We all strive for the democratic process, and we respect the web of existence. For we know that we are all interconnected and we're happier when we're all accepted. Love is the spirit and service is the call. This is my affirmation to one and all. I'm glad we are different and I'm glad we can share. It's effortless to be gentle when you care. I'll take action to improve the common good and I'll start right here in my own neighborhood. Our minds may reject it, but it is a key to stay open to new possibility. The point I'm making should be clear to you, to thy own self and to your brothers, always be true.
Thank you, Paul Paul Mathis. I'm always messing with him because I think it's the greatest joy ever to see. I would imagine I have no children, but my mother keeps bugging me for them, so it must be the greatest joy ever to know that you can be a grandparent because you don't have to chastise, you can just, you know, spoil. Next to the mic, the poets that I don't know, I will be coming up with interesting introductions for them. Word on the street that the next poet, she is a double dutch champion on the chitlin circuit. Y'all give her a warm round of applause. Pause, I can't talk. I'm gonna do some mouth exercises while I'm sitting down. Work on it. Y'all give her a round of applause. Miss Brittany Ward.
Double Dutch, but that was interesting. Hello, my name is Brittany Ward. I'm originally from Detroit, Michigan.
say that I appreciate this space. Like when I walked in, I appreciated the energy because it did remind me of home, so that's good. So, for my job here, I tutor students. So what we're gonna do today is go back to the classroom. So, hello class. Today's word, black privilege. I repeat, black privilege. Definition, having mental, physical ability as a melanating being. Origin, black privilege dates all the way back to working in the village, working in conditions where they called us nothing but field niggas. Freedom master never thought of, had us wading in the water, swinging low, sweet chariot, thanks Harriet, I'm trapped no longer. Strange fruit on trees, water brought us down to our knees. Martin King had a dream, Shabbat spoke by any means. But necessarily we woke up, put our fists up and they choked up. In all black we post up, black power we woke up. Surviving the worst adversity, it's the crime to be as dark as me. Sora Sandra couldn't stand you. Trayvon wanted Skittles and tea. Appropriation's inappropriate. I'm not your personal commodity. Just don't forget the history when you paint your face as dark as me. Physical, mental, or spiritual. You wish you could be so lyrical and versatile. Our dance moves is a miracle. The dope of the youth, the darker the skin, the darker the cool. When you see a queen, you know what to do. And excel in school where they fool you. Low numbers represent you. Your history month concerns you. Professors don't look like you. Always create the impossible. Madam CJ with the hot comb. Latimer gave us light. And Boykin gave us heart control. Shoes takes home the stolen gold. Black privilege cannot be sold.
That's right.
2016 and we still out here. Poison our city calls legionnaire. We'll make the signs, provide the care, while replacing structures everywhere. Black privilege. Thank you, class.